So welcome back. We are talking about the selection of bearings from analysis rat law. So up till now we have seen the few terms like bearing life and the load carrying capacity, that is static load carrying capacity and dynamic load rating. So also we have studied the equivalent radial load, how you can calculate by converting the axial load into radial load, because your manufacturer catalogs are available with the only radial load carrying capacities. So one relationship we have obtained also between the load and the life, with the help of which we can find out the requirement of the dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. So now we will talk about the selection of the bearings from the manufacturer's catalog. So the first step in the selection of a bearing from manufacturer's catalog, first thing is that you should calculate the radial load and the axial load, that is we write it as FR and FA acting on the bearing. This is the first step. Once you get the values of the FR and FA acting on the bearings, second thing is that you should check that whether you are having the diameter of the shaft. Okay, so if not, then you have to determine the diameter of the shaft on which the bearing is to be mounted. Then with these two things we'll move ahead, and then we have to select the type of bearing, means which type of bearing you have to select, whether you have to go for the ball bearing, or you have to go for the roller bearing, or you have to go for the taper roller bearing. So according to that you will select the type of bearing. Then for known shaft, begin with the selecting a bearing of the right series. So you know that there are different series of the bearings available. Like suppose if I say this is one type of bearing available for one particular diameter of the shaft, like this. Okay. Similarly now, you can have a bigger bearing being available for the same diameter of the shaft as the input. So means in this case you will find out that there is an increment in the width of the bearing, okay, as well as there is an increment in the outer diameter of the bearing. So while the bore diameter will remain same, even like third case you can have like this also, means you say your width of the bearing and diameter of the outer diameter of the bearing will go on changing for the same bore diameter. Okay, so one bearing will be like this, another will be like this. Okay, so you have to select the lighter series always, because definitely when the dimensions of the bearing are smaller, means the outer diameter and the width of it is smaller, definitely the cost of that bearing will be less. So we start with the light series first. Then find the value of the basic static capacity C0 of the selected bearing from the manufacturer catalog. So from in the catalog actually the value of C0 will be specified, so you have to select that value of C0 from the catalog. So your catalog will look like this. Suppose now this is a particular type of taper roller bearing, and suppose we have this particular diameter of bore as 70 mm. Okay, so for this 70 mm, now I should note the value of this C0, static load carrying capacity of this bearing. This I have to note and I have to move ahead, because I have to find out the value of this C, dynamic load rating, by using the load life relationship. So first I am selecting these two, means our diameter of bore diameter of this bearing like 70 mm is selected here, and value of C0 I am going to note it from here. Next step is to calculate the ratio of FA by V into FR and FA by CO. So CO we have got it from the manufacturer catalog, and FA and FR will be known to us from the given statement of the problem. And inner rest rotates or outer rest rotates, that factor has to be considered as V. So once you got this, so we have shown already that how we can select the value of this X and Y factors by taking the value of FA by V into FR and FA by CO. So corresponding to this you will get certain value of E, and then this value of E you have to compare with the value of this FA by V into FR ratio. So if it is more or less, according to that the value of X and Y will be collected from the catalog. So for a given application, find the value of the application factor or load factor, that is K value you have to find out depending upon the type of application of your bearing. Once you get this, then you have to calculate the equivalent dynamic load, that is P. This you have to calculate, that is K into in bracket X into V into FR plus Y into FA. So you will get this value of P. Now depending upon the application, make decision about the expected life of the bearing. So I have shown you how we can select the life of the bearing depending upon its application, and express that life in terms of million revolutions. So if this life is available to you in number of hours, so you have to convert that into million revolutions, that is in terms of L10. And once we get this, then you can use this particular relationship between the load and the life. So L10 you are going to get here, life in million revolutions. P you are going to calculate from using FA and FR and X and V and Y vectors. And then you have to use A depending upon whether it is a ball bearing, if it is 3, and if it is roller bearing it will be 10 by 3. So you have to calculate this value of C here, and then you have to check whether the selected bearing has the required basic dynamic capacity or not. So if not, go back to the step number 5. That means again you have to go for the selection of the next type of bearing. Okay, so this is what is the procedure for the selection of the bearing. It means if you got this value of C which is obtained here, means required value of C and available value of C, if it is more than this particular value of C, so that bearing will be okay for it. So just now let me show you once again that from where you will get that value. Like this is the value of that particular C, and your obtained value, if it is less than this particular value, so this bearing is okay for selection. Now sometimes you will find that the problem requirement will be such that you will be expecting the reliability of your bearing more than or less than 90%, because whatever the catalogs are available, so bearing catalogs are specifying the rating life of means 90% reliability. Okay, so all these catalogs are available at the reliability of 90%. So if you are expecting the life of your bearing other than 90% reliability or more than 90% reliability, in that case we have to make use of this particular equation. Okay, so what you are doing here, so reliability of bearing is predicted by Weibull distribution. So we are doing the Weibull distribution for predicting the life of the bearing, reliability of the bearing. So life of such bearing is to be calculated using L is equal to 6.844 into L10 into log to the base E of 1 by R bracket raised to power 1 upon 1.17. So using this expression we can find out the required value of L10, and once we get the L10, then we can select the value of C from the non-features catalog, and this L is nothing but the life required at a particular reliability which is being specified in your statement. So life required and the reliability required, these two here will be unknown to you, and this L10 will be unknown to you. So you have to calculate this L10 so that you can select that bearing from the manufacturer's catalog corresponding to this life and this reliability. And once we get that, if you have been asked to find out the reliability of the system, so that can be found out by using this equation. It means suppose there are four number of bearings in a particular system, so and it is having same reliability, so we can have reliability, its power, that is number of bearings, so we will be getting the system reliability. Okay, now one more case is possible. In some cases it is possible that the different kinds of loads are acting over the bearing, okay, and at different RPMs. Like if we take the example of a lathe machine, so in case of lathe machines we are doing different operations. So sometimes we are doing the knurling operation, so where the speed will be very less and load may be very high. Sometimes we are doing the turning operation, so there can be different speed and a different load. So when the condition is like this, that you are having the different loads and different speeds, so like this is P1, another P2, means different loads are acting for different number of revolutions. So like this PE1, I can say here PE1, first load, okay, acting at certain number of revolutions, N1, okay, then this is PE2 and there is N2, one that much number of revolutions your second load is acting. So when such a variable load is acting on a particular bearings, so in that case how we can find out the equivalent radial load. So to find out the equivalent radial load, when the loads are changing, means your overall load and the speed, they are changing. So when I send this PE1, it means actually this is being obtained by combination of radial and axial load. So initially you have to calculate all these PE1, PE2, PE3 and PE4, whatever is the number of loads are acting or radiations are there in the load on the bearings, and at what RPM these are being applied. So this formula gives me the equivalent radial load for bearing under cyclic load. So N1 into PE1 bracket raised to A plus N2 into PE2 bracket raised to A, actually this is the power of A, plus whatever number of bearings are there, divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3, like this total number, bracket raised to power 1 by 3. So these are nothing but the fraction of cycle for which the loads are acting, and these are the equivalent radial load for each element of the cycle. And then total rating life is given by the sum of this N1 to N1, N2, N3 to Nx. Okay, so this relation is also required to be used many a times to find out the equivalent radial load. So we'll just stop here, and then we will see in the next presentation some numericals will be solved with the help of these equivalent radial load formula or by using this bearings with probability of survival other than 90% and your basic load life relationship. So we'll stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.